If you are someone who frequents digital spaces, or even if you don't, chances are you have heard of the phrase revenge porn, also known as image-based sexual abuse or non-consensual pornography. It's a rampant evil of the digital world. The most common form of revenge porn? Online distribution of sexually explicit and graphic images or videos. Most common perpetrators? It's often a bitter ex. The aim? To publicly shame and humiliate the victim. But let's also talk about the etymology of this twisted phrase. As per the Oxford Dictionary, revenge is a noun, meaning something that you do to punish somebody who has hurt you, made you suffer. Now read that again. Revenge porn. We're essentially saying that the victim must have done something in the past to elicit such a violation of their privacy. Talk about victim blaming. Like we mentioned, the most common perpetrators of such acts are bitter exes. It's not just limited to romantic partners, a co-worker, a family member, a member of another clique in school. Some may have been broken up with, some may have been ghosted, and some may have felt humiliated by someone who turned down their advances. So they use images and videos to extract revenge or for blackmail. What drives this practice? Shame and guilt. A sexual partner may also take such images and videos without consent. So, from the act itself to the terminology, it almost seems carefully curated to induce shame and humiliation in the victim. They say once you upload something on the internet, it lives there forever. And with viral images comes the many comments and labels. Aren't you that person whose images went viral? Oh, have you seen this girl? Her image is on XYZ site. Don't you feel you should have been more careful while sharing these pictures? As per some studies, unsurprisingly, almost 3 out of 4 victims are women. However, image-based sexual abuse has seen male victims and female perpetrators. 1 in 20 adults in the US have been victims of image-based abuse, and 1 in 20 adults in the United States have reported being the perpetrators of the same. 1 in 3 teens report having seen explicit images of other minors, which, just for your information, qualifies as child pornography. People in the 18 to 29 age group are the most likely to fall victim to non-consensual image sharing, and people of color, low-income households, are more likely to be victims of image-based abuse. 17% of the LGBTQ+ people have either been threatened or have had their pictures shared. Intimacy and sexuality, they are considered sensitive subjects. Women and members of the LGBTQ+ community are especially expected to shun their choices and desires. And revenge porn, which sadly happens to be a rising trend, is reflective of the deep-rooted stigma, shame and guilt associated with it. Victims of image-based abuse experience severe disruptive mental health effects like PTSD, anxiety, depression, affecting familial and romantic relationships. Taking legal action isn't always easy and straightforward as well. Many countries do not have specific laws for this either, and often the process is emotionally draining and can cause more distress. To be able to report these crimes and for it to be investigated, it requires you to keep record of everything. So you may wish to forget and bury all evidence, but record and collect all data. There are sites that can ensure that your images aren't being used on sketchy websites and in videos. And there are helplines that can assist you. Studies suggest that 1 in 3 people in the 16 to 64 age group have been victims of image-based abuse, but a majority choose not to raise a complaint. The process truly is the punishment. But let's start here. Revenge porn is not revenge. It is image-based sexual abuse. It's a violation of the victim's privacy. Oftentimes, it's a control tactic. In many instances, it's child pornography. It's always non-consensual, and it's never the victim's fault.